Previously, we were moving segments around the sequence. Now let's look at how Autodesk Smoke works with sync. There are two considerations when it comes to sync. Firstly, there is keeping sync in the sequence when editing. So if you have lots of tracks and you're only inserting into a few areas, you are not knocking everything out of sync. Secondly, we work quite frequently with video and synchronous audio. For example, if you're cutting a narrative or interview spot. We'll try cover all these aspects in this video. Let's start off with keeping sync while editing. By default, when editing sources into the sequence, Smoke edits into the patched tracks as you would expect. However, there are plenty scenarios that can occur that throw the timeline out of sync. One common example is that I have two pieces of synchronous video and audio segments edited together. I would like to insert a video segment between the two as a cutaway or a break in the edit. But I only want to insert the video and not the audio. So the patch panel is set to edit the video and not the audio. I press F9 to perform an insert edit. The patched video track is edited, but nothing else. So my sequence is now out of sync because nothing was done to keep the other tracks in sync. This is where the sync locks come in. These are toggle buttons located in the patch panel for every track. You can click them to turn them on individually, or press Shift and click the video tracks, and then Shift and click the audio tracks. If I press Command Z to undo the old edit, and press the insert button again, Smoke will now insert gaps onto all the tracks to maintain the sync in the edit. Having this on when you're first assembling an edit is very helpful to keep overall sync. As you start refining your edit, you might want to turn them off to avoid creating unnecessary gaps in the sequence. I'll disable mine for now. These are just a few sync tips, but the choices are up to you. The other aspect of sync is working with video and its synchronous audio. This is quite common. You can import them in as a sync group if they were captured that way, or you could create a sync group from a separate video and audio segment. When looking at a sequence, the way you identify a sync group is that the segment description is underlined in all the related segments. Any other segments that are not underlined are just individual segments. Now you can tell Smoke just to select individual segments or select the sync group. This is all controlled through the link button located in this section of the editorial controls. When it is on, selecting any segment belonging to a sync group will select the entire group. This means as you move, trim, and edit segments around the sequence with their synced segments, you are able to keep perfect sync. For example, if you are experimenting with a potential edit. If link is turned off, then you can select any individual segment and move them around the sequence without their respective sync group. Even if you move the individual segments from the sync group, they will always be part of that sync group unless you explicitly break the sync group. This can be done by selecting the sync group and pressing Command L. The same keyboard shortcut will also create a sync group from individual segments. So if you have synced a separate video and audio source together, just press Command L to create a sync group from the segments. So this is how you can permanently break and create sync groups. Another useful function is that you can temporarily enable or disable the sync group when you are editing. For example, you can adjust one segment without breaking the sync group. Let's say that I want to trim out the video to create an offset edit. Even with link enabled, just hold Option and click on the segment you would like to affect. This temporarily selects just that segment and you can adjust it. Clicking the segment again, Smoke will reselect the whole sync group. The same goes in reverse. If link is off and you want to select a sync group without having to always toggle link on, just hold Option and click one of the segments in the sync group. This will select all the segments and you can perform your next operation with that selection. Without holding Option, Smoke will revert back to the regular behavior of selecting individual segments. The sync groups also have sync indicators when something is knocked out of sync. For example, moving other individual elements around the sequence could potentially knock something out of sync. For example, I'll turn Ripple on and press R to switch to the trim mode. I'll adjust the tail of a segment before a sync group. You can see that the audio segments of the sync group display frame indicators that tell you how many frames the audio is out of sync with the video. At this point, you can do a number of things. You can physically move the video segment back into sync with the audio or vice versa. You can also slip the audio or video frames. But Smoke also has a resync function. Right-click on the sync group. In the pop-up menu, you can choose Resync. This function will automatically slip the audio segment to be back in sync with the video without altering the edit. Another issue that can come up is when sync sound is slightly offset from the video. For example, audio that was captured during the filming of a faraway subject could create a slight delay between the action and the sound. The sync indicators think that the audio and video are in sync, although you know better. You can either turn off Link or use the option toggle I showed you earlier to select the audio separately. Now move the specific audio until you're happy it's in sync with the video. Of course, the sync indicators will tell you that the audio is out of sync. To fix this, right-click on the audio segments and choose Reset from the pop-up menu. This will reset the sync connection in the sync group between the video and the audio. The video and audio are now in sync, and the sync group now accepts the new offset as the correct sync between the segments. In the next video, you'll see how to do editorial match framing and source revealing in the sequence.